Welcome back, everyone. This is the fun block. We're in the E block. E for entertainment news. I'm going to start with this weekend's big box office bomb.
It's sad.
This is what we're all talking about. It is sad. It's sad. The Lone Ranger remake starring Johnny Depp, which as of last night grossed less than $10 million opening day. Look at how much they spent on the movie, how much it's raked in so far.
$10 million, if you gave that to any one of us, it would be a great day. However, it's not good.
No, and here's why.
Because this Western cost Disney $225 million to produce, and that put, let's put it into perspective here. Universal's Despicable Me 2 cost just $76 million to make, pulled in $34 on its opening day. Wow.
Rough weekend for Disney execs.
Joining us now, V103 radio personality Kendra G and co-host of the Ricky Smiley Morning Show, Ebony Steele. Good to have both of you here.
Good to be here. It's not BET.
Yes, right? Black Star Power. So let's talk about this. I mean, what is wrong with Disney? What's going on with this movie?
Well, you know what? I think nowadays critics are so important. I read a review about this movie that said, a movie for the family to see, to avoid, actually. Wow. And you can go to the movies and spend like your whole college tuition in a weekend. So the reviews to me are very important, and these didn't get good reviews.
Yeah. So. Last year was John Carter.
Right.
I mean, John Carter was the big $200 or $300 million project. Is Disney doing something wrong?
Well, I think for us to see this, you know, in a second year, and it happened again, almost repeating itself, it's almost showing our obsession or America's obsession with doing things and repeating them over again. I even saw a critic say, are writers getting lazy? Yeah.
Right.
Are people, you know, we've seen the Lone Ranger before. We know the movie.
Right,
and they're doing all of these remakes, and it's Disney like, hey, let's try to hold on to what the trend is, but is this working? Maybe not.
I think they need to go a different path.
Exactly.
I think this is a sign of that. And I know the hope is that international will do well, but usually Western movies don't do
well.
Great.
Exactly,
even with Johnny Depp.
He was great internationally, but they wonder, is he going to crack
And now there's a lot of other great movies coming here to the U.S.,
I don't think so.
Not looking too good for the Lone Ranger.
All right, so let's talk about this. I don't like this. Every year it comes up. It's hot dog eating competition. I can't. Every time I see it, I think about the smell of hot dog water. You know what
they
smell like?
It's one of those that you don't want to watch, but yet you do watch. You try to turn your head away.
It's like the train wreck.
How are these tiny people, especially the women, how do they do it?
Let me tell you something. Is this a job? Can you get paid for this? Because if so, I'm going to put some of my family members who are unemployed right now because they can eat hot dogs and they're eating them for free. You know what? I'm not a big fan of this. It's not that healthy, but it brought a lot of joy to the winner and then also to the people there. You know, this is also the area that was hit by Sandy Hook.
Yeah.
So it brought joy to them, but Lord, I need to put some of my family members up on there.
Yes. Well, what's interesting to me is how do you figure out you can do this? Do you just like run out of stuff at the grocery store and I've got 20 packs of hot dogs? You know what? Come on over, watch me, I can do this. Maybe we can make
some money. They have to practice.
Yeah.
And the women,
you talk about them, that I think it was 36.
It's amazing. Look at them, they're right here.
Yes.
And they're all tiny.
And the one that lost by 3/4 of a hot dog from what I understand.
It was such a slim margin.
How do you practice? They're probably tiny
because they're probably not eating until this competition. They probably start themselves for a little while.
Wow. You know what gets me every year is that this airs on ESPN. Is this a sport?
Is it a sport? Look, I think it kind of is. Everybody has a talent, Victor. Don't be a TV. You know?
There you go. Every time you come, you always try to do something like that.
We're going to put you to the test.
Okay. So here's a bizarre one.
Okay.
All right. So people sell a lot of things at auctions online. Some anonymous person and really rich person spent about $6,000 for a clump of Mick Jagger's hair.
And it wasn't
this
new
is a head scratcher. No pun intended.
Well, wait a minute, Ebony. Would it be better if it was new hair?
I'm trying to think about it. I'm like, okay, $6,000 at an auction, and yes, it was for a charity, but what is this going to lead to? Are people going to start, I mean, guys are going to start stealing women's eyelashes and
maybe.
Putting them on eBay?
I am a fan of this. Now, I wouldn't buy Mick Jagger's hair, but if I
was going to say, whose hair would you buy?
Oh, I would buy one of Michael Jackson's old wigs.
Oh my God,
I'd be the talk of the town if I had to.
Yeah, I mean, that would probably be worth something. You can invest it. But here's the other thing. Keith Richards tried to sell some of his hair.
$1,300. $1,300. We can say, well, let's see what the barber has to use.
I'm holding on to the little bit I have left.
You're doing good.
I got to hold on to it. I'm not spending this.
You got to crawl before you walk, before you run.
I'm trying. That's right.
Baby
steps. Kendra G, Ebony Steele, thank you so much.
Thank you.
I listen to you in the mornings. Every weekday. I thank you both.
Thank you.
Thanks, Victor.